When does it register? Okay, this time it took a little bit longer. But yeah, if you actually read the title, I don't think what I'm actually going in, typing in there, but whatever. Yeah, this is actually serious. My very first time playing a Metroid game at all. And since this is free, this is basically perfect for me to actually jump right into it. And yeah, the only thing I did is testing a little bit what I can do around here. Also, it's a little bit loud around here, mostly on my end. I would say on minus 15. But even though it's my very first Metroid game, I still know everything about this game. Even though I only have seen the original of it. And I think they should have been set in the options. Everything is normal. And yeah, doing normal game. Because yeah, I don't want to go easy, especially not hard. So yeah, let's go in. Metroids. Numerous incidents in the past have brought to light the highly destructive power of these life forms, spreading fear across all non-planetary systems. Okay, I'm quick enough to read all of this. Hoping to secure peace in the galaxy, the Galactic Federation orders the extermination of the Metroid species. I was the best candidate for the job. It's basically Samus Aran. Once again, I find myself standing alone against the Metroid menace, and what horrors await me within the depths of their homeworld? I know already, but anything else? It's a nice pixel artwork, that's for sure. Going in completely blind except what I have actually seen all around over here. And yeah, what can I do? Jump and shoot. And I know what I currently have. Which button was it again? Yeah, it's over here. The power suit, normal stuff, standard armor suit, the morph ball. I can go into a ball. The usual stuff, but I can't jump with it yet, I think. And a power grip. It's not that useful because it's not that much shown. Mostly only when grabbing ledges like so. Or something like this. I want to shoot you, so please. Oh yeah. Oh, whoops. Wrong button. Actually, how did I do this? Also, I can't go in. Wait a sec. How did I do this? I don't know how to curl into a ball. Well, we'll see for sure. Okay, at specific places, I would say. Going through over here. I mean, cutting all of this in parts for YouTube would be something, because this game isn't that long. Get over here. But I'm so almost. Nah, I don't want to curl. There we go. And no ledge grab. Also, which way should I go? I think I should go to the left first. There isn't that much going around here either way. Also, the game is very short, as I think I've said it already. God damn it. I would like to get health back, please. Oh, water again, yeah. I was around here and it's a little bit... Yeah. Ah, the usual. Limited mobility. so I have to jump over. I have to get to used to everything, and saving and healing, usual stuff. Okay, what's over here? This is basically the area which I stopped and went back and went to the right side, but stopped on that save point. So, wait a second. I think... Nah, I'm still able to continue onward. Uh-oh. First boss, so to speak. Wait a second. Ah! Okay, I got a little bit, filled up again. But yeah, that's one section. I don't want to cut it already! Because, yeah, should now say... Nah, depends if it gets, And I don't want to say anything because I don't think I have the correct word. Getting actualized? Nah. Getting updated, there we go. In terms of the Metroid counter up there. Also, I would like to see, can I... I might need to... Not there, nah, god damn it. Down here, options, controls... Press up and down while aiming to choose direction. I want like to go out. Oh, but I did this already. Okay, onward. Whatever. God damn it. Onward. And I would... Nah, god damn it. Okay, it's still a little bit clunky. I don't know if it's always like this or because of my current setup. What I have quote unquote configured or let the game have configured for me as default. Because, yeah. I'm basically a total noob at this game, since it's basically my first time, so I don't know what I'm doing. Okay, another safe spot then. Wait a second, did I changed it? God damn it. Wrong button again. Controls. I did this. Or was it set to 1? There we go. Still a little bit of clunky controls. I don't know how I can actually stand still and aim in all directions. Can I actually? Ah, okay. Now I have the button where I can actually roll into a ball. But where can I? Ah, I can do all of this. Ah, okay. Since I'm playing with a controller, it's R2 to aim like this. Ball. Wait a second. R2 to roll into a ball. L2 to aim. To aim up. To aim down. No, I don't want to use. There we go. Okay. Now I should have everything. There we go. Ah! God damn it. There we go. Almost healed up fully. Ah. I need to get the hang of these controls. There we go. All of this cleared. Okay, it spawned. At the very last second. Ah, you can live, whatever. Get away. Get off. Okay, next part. Of course, I can't go down here yet. Only after I cleared the next section. Screw you. There we go. There we go. Ah! No, come up. There we go. Screw you. Hello? There we go. Ah! Come up again. There we go. And full health again. Okay, that I didn't saw. And I would say next Metroid over here. Wait. Isn't this? Ah, okay, it's one of those. Okay, I might need to go up then. I don't know if I should go up. Well, you're safe and sorry. Can always go back. Go away, come on. Ah! And Golden Temp, I'm here already? Also, pause for a second. Okay, I press the start button to go to the menu, but okay, the Golden Temple. This temple stands at the base of a hollow mountain. The statues, carved stones, and its solid design attest that the structure was built to be a sanctuary, possibly a religious significance. The temple has withstood the test of time, showing the building, knowledge, and experience of the Chozo. Yeah, that's that then. Scans detected the presence of stationary robotic entities placed at strategic points inside the structure. No control signals are detected. These units are operating autonomously. And I wasn't paying attention to most of all this. So yeah, since I get all of this, I should actually read them. Since maybe I get some information here. Well, mission briefing. Primary objective. Exterminate all Metroid organisms on planet SR388. Yeah, pronunciations and stuff on how it's actually supposed to be pronounced, I don't care. I am just here to play this. Secondary objective, locate and bring assistance to the Galactic Federation research and rescue teams. Okay, planet SR... did I miss-said in terms of 288? It's 388. I don't even remember what I said, so whatever. Planetary designation SR388, a remote planet absent on most galactic charts. Federation research indicates it is a natural homeworld of the Metroid species. Its outer crust is hollowed out with massive cave systems, which are home to an ecosystem that is yet to be fully studied. I'm the first around here then. No, wait a second, the second I think. No, third because of the Chozo? Second because of the rescue team, and third because of me. The first expedition to SR388 revealed the existence of Chozo ruins. Yeah, of course. Earthquakes. Yeah, that's what happened before. The massive cave system is located between two tectonic plates, largely flooded by an extremely dense and caustic substance similar to magma. The recent earthquake has altered the cave layout, and the hazardous substance has drained to lower levels, and that's how we get forward. The cause of the earthquake is unknown. Initial orbital scan of SR388 detected no instability within this region. But it has something to do with the Metroids. More on that later. And the rescue team. Okay, what are they doing actually? For years, the Federation declared SR388 unsafe to initiate new expeditions. However, after recent orbital scans failed to detect any Metroid presence on the planet's surface, the dispatch of a research vessel was finally approved. The crew mission was to inspect the region where the species was first encountered and reaffirmed that none remained. Period. Whoops, I thought this, the sentence continues, but nah. Their next objectives were to explore the nearby Chozo ruins and study SR388's other wildlife. Communication with the team was cut off, and only a distress signal managed to reach HQ. And wait a second. No, fourth then. Okay, first the Chozos, then the research team, then the rescue team, and then me. There we go. The search and rescue... Why is it only rescue team and then saying it's a search and rescue team? Whatever. The search and rescue team is an elite combat group consisting of healthy... healthy. I mean, yeah, they should be healthy as well. Heavily armed soldiers. Their mission? Locate and extract any surviving personnel from the missing research team. The group reported finding a specialized energy sensor at the campsite of the missing team. Okay. It's later confirmed the Federation's suspicions. Metroids still thrive within the planet. These findings were sent to HQ to be analyzed. While the group continued their search for survivors, contact was soon lost with them as well. Of course, maybe they died. The data sent to HQ revealed an approximate number of Metroids remaining on SR388 and was ultimately used to develop a scan module for your power suit. Okay, it's directed to me then. This allows the detection of nearby energy readings unique to the species. But it needs to be updated regularly, because it still says it's zero currently. The Metroid species. The dominant species of SR388, Metroids hunt for any form of energy found in natural or synthetic organisms, leaving behind deceased husks after feeding. They're highly resistant to conventional weapons and possess great adaptability in foreign environments. SMA suggests a small number of Metroids set loose on a populated planet would lead to an extinction of any present life forms. Because of course. They have drawn much attention from space pirates who have repeatedly tried to use them as biological weapons. Ahem. Life circle. That's what we actually found out. Wait a second, more on that once I get to that part. Scans on the native Metroids revealed their most common form in prior incidents is... Scans of the native Metroids revealed their most common form in prior incidents is merely the species' larval state. It's a state, alright, but also a stage. While there are records of extreme mutations triggered by I wanted to say private pirates, what the fuck? By space pirates using abnormal stimuli, the Metroid homeworld of SR388 is seemingly the only environment where the species can naturally transform. Okay, Alpha Metroid, that's what we encountered. Wait a second, why is it an Alpha Metroid even though the lava stage is actually the most powerful, so to speak? Depends if you know the game already. Basically, know the Metroids and stuff. The Alpha Metroid has gained immunity to cold temperatures, but only cold ones, it seems. But also several nuclei within its green membrane. Membrane? I think I said it correctly. Has left it vulnerable to concussive? Weaponry. God, forget it. I can't read. A plated exoskeleton partially covers it. Okay, that's a little bit short for a sentence. This organism emerges from the molting of its larval form. Though aggressive, it is relatively weak at this stage. Because, yeah, of course, its new appendages have yet to grow to their full length and strength. Yeah, the Golden Temple, we saw this one already, but not the Lost Race entirely. The Chozo were an ancient and mysterious avian race. I wanted to say space, what is this? Incredibly advanced, they colonized many worlds, spreading their message of peace throughout the universe. There are historical records and legends of the Chozo visiting other races with whom they shared their knowledge and wisdom. These brief encounters led many primitive cultures to their present-day glory. Some say they helped consolidate the very foundations of the Galactic Federation. The fate of this race is unknown. Evidence suggests they slowly vanish from the cosmos over the course of centuries. All that remains on each planet they inhabited are the ruins of their once glorious civilization. And hostilities, native species. Yeah, everything that flies and bugs me everywhere. And I need to drink after that. And also cut this part for YouTube. For the re-upload. Not much is known about SR388's ecosystem. Prior reports... wait a second, did we have this already? Nah, it's another report, I would say. Prior reports described the fauna as being very hostile. I mean, yeah. Nearly all observed animals have been carnivores, with even the smallest species showing dangerous traits. The harsh environment and the presence of so many predators may have forced an evolutionary arms race, perpetuating a circle of violence. Extreme caution is advised. I mean, of course, because it's killed or be killed. Wait a second. It's basically the same what I just said. It's killed or be killed. There we go. And I'm not playing Undertale yet. But whatever, I'm doing the first part right now then. And for that part, it's that then.